Welcome back. This video is going to be helping you fix the memory management blue screen in Windows. Normally this blue screen isn't too serious unless it's happening frequently. The common causes of this error are either a faulty video or graphics card, a problem with your computer's memory, or its drivers. If this error is preventing you from getting into your computer, you may want to try rebooting in safe mode. I'll put a link to a video explaining how to do that in the description. If this is occurring, the issue is likely to do with your computer's RAM, and you should check that it is installed correctly, and if it is rather old, it may need replacing. You can watch the video in the description showing you how to install and replace RAM in your computer. If this issue is occurring either once or frequently, but you do have access to your computer, meaning that it's letting you on, then we will now look at the solutions. The most likely cause of this error is a faulty or outdated graphics card driver. You need to make sure that your graphics card driver is up to date. To install and check for the latest version, you need to know what graphics card you have. If you know already, you should be able to find the latest driver on the manufacturer's website. For example, Nvidia will have them available. I'll try and put links to the sites to get them from in the description. If you're unsure of which graphics card you have, I'll put a link to a video explaining how to find that. Once you've installed the latest drivers, hopefully the blue screen won't appear again. It is still worth following the rest of this video just to make sure the problem isn't caused by something else, and if it is still happening, hopefully one of these solutions will fix it. The next thing we will try is to run a memory diagnostics test. To run this test, you will need to restart your machine. To initiate the test, go to Run by searching Run in the search bar, and then type in mdsched.exe, then click OK. You can return to this video after you have restarted and once the test is complete. Now all you need to do is let your computer run the test and it will tell you the problems if there are any. If it does find a problem, then the main issue likely lies with your computer's RAM and it may need to be replaced or checked. Another test that may fix the error, especially if it is caused by corrupted system files, is SFC Scan Now. To run this test, go to the command prompt by searching CMD in the search bar, and make sure you right click and run as administrator. Then you need to enter the command sfc/scan now. You need to let this test run, and it may take some time. I recommend not using your PC whilst it is running the test, so feel free to exit the video at this point and return later. Hopefully one of these solutions will have fixed or highlighted the problem you have. If they have, then you will have a better understanding of the issue causing it, and you can take the necessary steps to fix it, such as replacing your RAM. If they haven't, there are a few other things you could try. Firstly, has there been any changes to your PC that may have created this problem? Perhaps a recent update or new piece of software? If there has been changes, try uninstalling or reverting back to how it was before to see if the problem continues. You also need to consider hardware and other changes. Perhaps you've just started using a new mouse, keyboard or headset. Driver conflicts could be a reason you are getting this error. Finally, a virus may be the problem. It could have corrupted your Windows files. To rule this out, run a virus scan and try to remove it if possible. That's all the things I have for you to try. Feel free to share your problems in the description to see if anyone else has any support or advice. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in another video.